everybody. This is Sophia Declamery, assistant professor, belongs to the Department of Sociology and Social Work, Fatima College. I'm glad to meet you through this video. Dear students, hope you're all staying safe at home, maintaining social distance and keeping yourself healthy. Let us start the concepts and theories of social change. Before getting into the theories, we'll start with the concepts so that you will get an idea and it will be easy for you to understand the theories of social change. Concepts. The first and the foremost concept is change. Any alteration, difference or modification that takes place in a situation or in an object through time is known as change. Progress. Improvement, betterment, going up from a lower situation or position, a change or an advance towards a desirable end is known as progress. Evolution implies continuous change that takes place in some structure is known as evolution. Revolution, a fundamental and relatively a sudden change in the structure is known as revolution. Even you can take this current situation, what's happening in everyone's life presently, the COVID-19 pandemic situation can also be referred to this revolution, because all of a sudden change has taken place in each and everyone's life which was never expected. Development. The process of creating something more advanced, it creates growth, positive change of physical, economic, environmental, social and demographic components. Hope these concepts you are familiar. If you are clear, it will be easy for us to make ourselves familiar to the theories of social change. I would like to show you some pictures. You have to guess which picture is related to which concept. The first picture, can you guess it? Yes. Exactly, it is related to change. The second picture, it is related to progress. Third one is related to evolution. Then fourth one is related to revolution. Then the next picture is related to development. Now moving to the theories of social change. There are various theories, evolutionary theory, cyclical theory, functionalist theory and conflict theory. But we are going to focus only on evolutionary theory and cyclical theory in this video. Evolutionary theory. Societies gradually change from simple beginnings into even more complex forms. For this evolutionary theories, I have taken two authors, namely August Comte's Unilinear Theory and Herbert Spencer's Social Darwinism. August Comte's Unilinear Theory. Societies gradually change from simple beginnings into even more complex forms. Comte believed that human societies evolve in a unilinear way, that is, in one line of development. According to them, social change is progress towards something better. They saw change as positive and beneficial. The evolutionary process implied that societies would necessarily reach new and higher levels of civilization. During 19th century, a lot of changes were taking place, especially happened among the primitive people, that is, among the tribal community. Early anthropologists made some attempt to study the primitives and their societies. Based on their observation, they argued that universal evolutionary process. They also claimed that in the beginning, all societies passed through number of stages. L.H. Morin had given three basic stages in the process, namely savagery, barbarism and civilization. Comte's ideas relating to three stages in the development of human thought and also society, namely the theological, the metaphysical and the positive, in a way represent the three basic stages of social change. He explained that human thought has developed based on three stages, namely the theological, the metaphysical and the positive. For this, he explained that theological stage, which is similar to the primitive societies, they believe on nature. Then metaphysical stage, which is similar to rural society, because they believe the nature, and slowly they started to think rationally. And in the positive stage, which is similar to the urban society, where they are highly rational. Next, moving to the Herbert Spencer's social Darwinism. Herbert Spencer, influenced by Charles Darwin's theory of organic evolution, he argued society itself is an organism. He applied Darwin's principle of survival of the fittest to human societies. He said society has been gradually progressing towards better state. He argued that it has evolved from military society to industrial society. He claimed that Western races, classes or societies had survived and evolved because they were better adapted to face the conditions of life. This view is known as social Darwinism. Hope you are clear with Herbert Spencer's social Darwinism. Moving to cyclical theory. This theory focuses on the rise and fall of civilizations, attempting to discover and account for these patterns of growth and decay. For this theory, I would like to take two of the authors, Oswald Spengler's The Destiny of Civilization and Arnold Toynbee's Challenge and Response. Oswald Spengler, The Destiny of Civilization. Each civilization is like a biological organism and has a similar life cycle, birth, maturity, old age and death. After making a study of 8 major civilizations, including the West, he said that the modern Western society is in the last stage, that is old age. He concluded that the Western societies were entering a period of decay, as evidenced by wars, conflicts and social breakdown that heralded their doom. This theory is almost out of fashion today because this idea is too unrealistic, mystical and speculative. Next, we are going to move on to Toynbee's Challenge and Response. Every society faces challenges at first. Challenges posed by the environment, later challenges from internal and external enemies. The nature of the response determines a society's fate. The achievements of a civilization consist of its successful responses to challenges. If it cannot mount an effective response, it dies, says Ian Robertson. He says that it depends upon the society how it faces the challenge and respond to it. Finally, I would like to conclude. All these concepts and theories of social change shows the different perspectives of the authors and their keen observation of the phenomena, that is, what's happening in the society. I hope I am clear to you to share the theories of social change. Hope it was helpful to you and now you become familiar with the theories of social change given by various authors. Thank you. Hope you are all staying safe at home.